I'd like to welcome all the people joining our webinar today. A very warm welcome from my side. Today we like to talk about new features in our Mask Integrator. Our Mask Integrator software has a few new features. Before we start through the agenda, I like to give the microphone to Robin, our CEO, to give a few words to you as well.
Yeah, hi, my name is Robin. For those who don't know me yet, I'm the CEO of Picture Instruments. Picture Instruments is a German company, so please excuse us if our English is not always 100% perfect. Today, it's more than 6 years that we released the first version, the first software, which was Mask Integrator. Today, we have a lot more standalone applications, as well as Photoshop, Lightroom, and video plugins. But back to Mask Integrator, which is the software we are talking about today. Thorsten Schirpe, who is the inventor of the Hensel FreeMask system, brought me to the idea to make a software to batch process series of two image couples containing a regular photo as well as a corresponding backlit photo for luminance masking. Since our first version of Mask Integrator, we got a lot of customer feedback and the software has developed very much further, resulting in complete 360-degree photo systems, including hardware and software. On the one hand, we have developed complete systems, including LED lighting, glass turntable, backlit. But on the other hand, we can also offer 360-degree background removal solutions, which work with existing flash lights or flash systems. In each upcoming webinar, we will deepen a particular topic, and Jörg starts today with an overview about the newest functions in Mask Integrator.
Thank you, Robin. I just go back to my agenda. So that's what we like to talk about today. We have a few small new things implemented in our software. It's the position of the windows. I will talk a few seconds. The transparency patterns in the background, the fallback brush, and the detect newcomer with autosave. These is small things in the settings of the software. The really interesting features for our customers maybe could be the so-called stain or dust remover. The possibility for you to do a mask smoothing around the mask now. We have a new feature which we called object rotation by value, which means that you have the possibility to rotate your object by after taking the pictures, importing to Mask Integrator in the Mask Integrator software. And we will show a really new feature we call artificial shadows. This is a beta version. Please keep in mind what you see today is not an official release, but we'd like to show you what you will have in the next few weeks. At the end, I will talk a little bit about upcoming webinars in the future, what we are intending to do. Like we will do a working with photo systems we create. We will show a little bit our hard and software features to get a full system. We will talk about at one webinar about creating real 3D data, which is a very nice feature we can do now with our machines. And of course, we will also take a look of our customers, which our customers are interested in. So I've loaded an example, which is an LED light you can see here. In this first topic, I like to talk about position of the software when closing, which means if you work with our hardware and software features, you can use our serial shot to get the camera working and get the files handled. you can open our mask integrator parallel to SerialShot to do your masking. And we got nice little tools like crop and resize. If you positioning all these software components on your screen and you finished your work and close the software tools, we will keep in mind how these windows were arranged at your working area, which means if you restart the software, you will get the same order of these software tools and you can work always in the same positions, like if you use a second monitor or if you have a special place on your monitors for the software. The second feature we have implemented is this checkerboard pattern in the background you will see, which you can now change with this transparency grid color and the transparency size of the grid. So, which means if I go here smaller or bigger, you will see how this checkerboard is changing now the size or the color in the future. This makes sense for people which will have a very bright object maybe and they have a little bit darker theme in the background. So everybody can create his own working area who likes to do it in their own way. The next feature we have implemented is a so-called fallback brush, which means if you work with our hardware, you can load a standard brush after creating your pictures and masks by starting the software if you don't have any brush before loaded or if you don't have any brush in the SerialShot settings implemented. So you got a standard brush to get a little bit faster the work done. Next feature will be the auto detecting of newcomers with autosave, which is implemented here in the area of the photo, which means if the SerialShot sends a new photo and mask to the software, we will detect the newcomer automatically. If you change and work on your mask and you click on autosave, we will save this brush automatically after the next, before the next pictures will come. In our example work now and today, I will don't click it on autosave, that if I change anything on my mask here, or if I work with a mask, that I not always get it saved, which I don't need to have today. So let's start with the first feature, which is called our stain remover. But before I will, for the people which don't know so much about the software or not so familiar with our software, how to create the first mask in Mask Integrator. You see here, and here's the photo loaded, my image for the LED. This is this one here, which is created by a photographer with some cardboards in the background. You can switch here to the actual state of the mask, and you got here the result after creating the mask. You see that my mask histogram here, the mask histogram is on the right hand, left hand side. I have nothing done now, I have nothing created. First of all, I go to this small choosing of the edge detector. The edge detector is quite necessary if you start in creating a new mask. How to see the mask is changing if I go on the left, if I go on the right, to get my work done to create a perfect mask. You see how this edge detector is changing. You see the magenta information around here. But what you also see is if I have some cardboards inside which have an influence of my mask, which I don't need. You see these cardboards I never will need in my mask. I will do, first of all, look for removing these cardboards by hand if I take something like this. You see my mask is now quite nice, but you see also in these areas and these areas, we will have some dust maybe on our glass plate. how to remove this. We got this new function, so-called stain remover. And if you take a look what I do, I go up here, maybe to 10, to 20, I can go up and up and up, and you see how the turquoise border, which shows my border of the mask, is going automatically nearby the first transparent pixel, which is
not transparent pixel.
And here, and here, and here. And you see around my object, my edge detector. I go on and off. If I go back here with my stain remover, you see how the mask is changing and it goes back. And if you take a look here, you see this little dust on the background. I can see here, around here, there is maybe some dust in the background, which we remove automatically with the stain remover. So I go back to the about 120, 150. Now I have a nearly perfect mask. If I take a look around, everything looks fine. And now I can do my fine adjustments on my mask. I can take a look if everything like I did. And this is all what I need to do using this new function of the stain remover.
Let me add one technical information about the stain remover. The number in the field, the 132, it's the amount of pixels which are together to be removed. So this means if you push the slider to 10, pixel groups up to 10 pixel will be removed, and 132 means pixel groups up to 132 will be removed. So the bigger the number, the bigger the amount of pixels which will be removed.
Yeah, so if you click on the button nearby on the right hand side of this stain remover, we show you all the pixels which we have removed in our example. So if you click it on or off, you can see, but this example is so less of dust, and I will show in another example how you can see which parts we are removing with this stain remover function. The next functionality we like to show you is the so-called mask smoothing. I will load another example.
While Jörg is loading the next example, let me tell you that the stain remover not only removes single pixel groups around the subject, but also closes a very small group of pixels inside the subject. This results in that you don't have to compress the mask so much.
If you see this new example, it's a sheep. It's done in the same way like the example before. You got this photography, you got this first mask. I have the same situation as before. First of all, I have to create my mask. If I don't have it done before, I don't have a standard brush loaded. You see how the turquoise mask is showing our borders, our box in which we are creating. And now you see these very nice features of the mask blurring. I will close this for you, that it's a little bit easier. My mask blurring is now at zero. My stain remover is also on zero. I got a good mask without any stain removing because I don't have any dust on this example. If I go up for the mask blurring, you will see how the mask is changing around here. So let me do it a little bit more to see how it changes. You see the, and this is a very nice feature to get all these things handled with transparency. That you, I go back to zero and do a little bit more zoom in for you. If you see what we get here, we get all these little stuff which is in a transparency situation. If I'm blurring the mask now, maybe with 2 pixels, you see how it's done. And if I go on a white or on a black, black is maybe a little bit better for you to see the transparency in the situation from the object to the background. I go back to 0. You see this, is, which maybe looks very hard in a 1x1. And if I go up with my slider here to maybe 2, I got a quite nice solution for a perfect mask in combination with my background. So this is the reason to take a look on your results before you save or export, that you have the possibility for transparency for white and black background to make your mind up if this is the best choice for you or if you need to go higher or less high. This was the mask smoothing. It works very well, very fast. What you see is what you get in real time. Next was our feature object rotation by value. I will load another example to show you. Mask. I will show you the whole picture. So, this is the photography. This is an example done with our machine. You see in the background our backlight. You see our glass turntable. You see a little bit from the situation outside the room. This is the mask. This is the result on transparency. I can create my mask in a way like I did before with the other two examples. And what I like to show here is the situation is a little bit complicated in photography because this object was not able to get fixed very good on the glass plate because it is a very small diameter here that it will fall down. That's the reason why the photographer has to turn about 180 degrees and shoot it on the 180 degree situation. What we do now is with this new function rotation, we have the possibility to turn around in the photography. We don't need to do that later in other functions like our crop and resize or Photoshop. We can do here. So I go to these image manipulations, we call it, in the rotation window. I put in 180 degrees and I turn my picture in the right way. I can do fine adjustments as well as if this object is not perfect and maybe I need to have 179 maybe. Yeah, you see what's changing. I can go with the manipulator by hand as well. Yeah, if I choose anything like this. So it's a very, very nice feature to get a very fine adjustment as well. I need to do 180. So what you see now here, we called before about the stain remover is a nice interesting feature. If you place your object in a real transparent situation like this one, this is a full transparent object, and if you use the stain remover and you decide for a too high level, you can see what happens with full transparent objects, that we will cut off these areas of pixels. What Robin explained before, this amount of pixels, if it's too high, we will cut off in a transparent object as well. So you see, if I go too high, I lose letters. So keep in mind, if you work with transparent objects, don't go too high with this amount. Next in the new feature list is our artificial shadow. I will load another object to show you the new shadow function. You see, we keep our rotation in the next pictures automatically. I go back to zero because I don't need to do anything with this object. And zoom out that you can see. I don't need to talk too much about create the mask. You've already seen, but what I can show here is the first we discussed, the stain remover. I can show you very good in this explain it. You see the dust here around the object, a little bit dust. And now if I do no blurring and I go up with the stain remover, I will cut off these things. And now the function is nice to see. If I switch on and off here my small button, I can see these areas are all, I might do more zoom in for you. You see these areas will be removed automatically by our software. Yeah, this is the result without the dust. If I switch on, you see we are removing this. This is a good functionality for you to control what you cut off. If I go down here, maybe to 50, you see the small things like this ones here are deleted. But the bigger ones up here are not deleted because the pixel is more than 31. I have to go higher here. And now we will also remove this. And you see, nothing happens inside the object. That's quite necessary to see that we don't cut off any dust inside the object. If there will be dust on the object here, I will keep it. I don't remove it, that I don't get any holes inside, which will I see here. If I will remove any dust inside my object and mask, I will look through the transparent background maybe. So we only remove outside the object in the mask. This is quite necessary. Don't get a black hole inside here.
If there are holes, the stain remover would close the holes if there would be very small holes.
Yeah. So I switched to my white background. I gave a little bit mask blurring, maybe for, I choose maybe two, maybe like this. And now we can create our artificial shadows. I click on the functionality here to implement the shadow, and I have these sliders here to decide and create how to get the shadow. I can do a shadow intensity, I do with this slider. I can do a blurring of the shadow, I do with this. You see how the shadow is going bigger or smaller. And I have the function for a vertical offset of my mask, which will do something like this. It gets a little bit more like a natural shadow if my light will come from the top. And I go back maybe to the blurring if I need to have it a little bit harder, depending on my needs, on my situation, how to do my work for my customer. And this shadow is now implemented together with my background, together with my object. And if I export or save my file, I will keep it. Now we can maybe do that, and I will show the shadow one time in Photoshop for you. If I save these, we go back to Photoshop, I can open and show you the result.
We can't see Photoshop at the moment.
Yeah, just a second. I will open and switch back to my... Just a second, I'm sorry for that. I need to take a look on the... But you see Mask Integrator, right?
Yes.
That's okay, I see, because... Photoshop. So Photoshop is now Okay. Yes. This is the result in Photoshop. You see my shadow we created, and if you take a look on the channels, you see there's a quite good quality. There's green, blue. So you got a result like this. But keep in mind, we are just working on this feature. It's not the released and end functionality of all these, because we are just deciding a little bit and discussing how the sliders will be created. Maybe we will implement one slider more, or something will be changed. So we are just in work in progress with this.
You showed the shadow on a white background. I would like to mention that it also will work on a transparent background.
So we can export with transparent background as well. This is the result in transparent background. You see here the shadow. Good. So go back to Mask Integrator. One more thing, because we got these questions of customers in the last webinar, how to work with the functionality of LOTs, like lookup tables. I will show a small explanation about this. I load my sheep once more for you to show you how this works. Okay, after the photography of my sheep, I put it in a white background. I see that maybe my camera is not working perfect on maybe the reds. Some cameras have the problems with reds maybe. So I created a LOT with a red correction. I load my LOT, and if you take a look, I can make a little bit bigger for you. I got a better red. That means that I can create in Photoshop LOT for special colors, for tonal correction, what you like. You export this LOT as an own personal correction LOT, and you load it in our software, and after the shooting, you get these automatically corrected if you need, and so you don't need to go back to Photoshop after creating your mask, exporting the results. You can work in progress without using Photoshop. You can adjust the percentage, how it's done. So it means if you think it's too much with 100, you can go up to 60. And you got a very, very nice feature to make standard corrections for your lighting, for your camera, for your objects, if you need. Okay, that's for now.
I think lookup tables is a very, very complex topic where we can talk about a lot. Maybe if you're interested, we can do a separate seminar only about lookup tables, because we have several applications regarding lookup tables and color corrections. In a lookup table, you can save pretty much everything which is related to contrast changes, color changes, brightness changes. You can make any adjustments in Lightroom, Photoshop, or any other app and save it to a lookup table. And if you have the same situation with lighting and with your camera and with the complete surrounding, and you have a special lookup table for this environment, you can apply it either on each image in Mask Integrator or in the post-processing when we are talking about our crop and resize software in another webinar later.
I got two questions. Jaron Wiegmann asks, you talk about dust, but it's for every type of stain or spot issues. Yeah, that's right. It's not only dust, it's for every issue you got outside your object. This is quite necessary to understand. Like I showed before, if I go one more time in my stain remover, I cut off my stain remover to zero. I show my result, but I don't have so much dust.
You have to go with the handles in the histogram a little bit more to the outside, so the stain comes back. If you compress the image a lot, maybe stain removes anyway. But in this image is a perfect example for small hairs and fine details. And if you compress the details too much, the hair is going away or is heavily compressed. And the more you can put the both handles in the histogram to the outside, the better the quality of the hair and fine details is. So the stain remover helps you to make a better mask with more details in fine details like hair.
Yeah, you see in this example very nice what Robin talks. I switch off. All this stuff is removed by the choice of 67. You see these areas, but also some of things like here. If I go a little bit
smaller. In the inside, that's okay. These are holes which will be closed.
You see, but outside as well, there's no direct connection between these pixels or these stain or dust with my object and my mask. So it's quite nice to remove it. So if I go higher, you see how the size of pixels is changing, which we remove. Like here, all this stuff which is flying around my object, maybe. So this is quite nice to check about my amount of stain removing, and I can play a little bit with this. So it means if you have 20 of these objects with pet things, so if I choose maybe 25 or 45, it doesn't matter what I choose here. For the next photography coming into our software, we will do it in the same way, though you got the same results for nearly the same objects. If you next is an elephant, and we remove the dust with 51 as well without changing here. And normally you can use the same mask for all the objects. You never create another mask, because if you have done this mask very nice, it will work for other objects in the same lighting situation as well.
As long as you don't change the shutter speed or ISO or lighting of the subject, yeah.
Okay, so from my side, I'm fine. If anybody needs to have additional information, please write it into the chat. I see another question. It's possible to use Mask Integrator easily on transparent objects, glass or plexiglass. Thank you, like this example, perfect. Yeah, you can use on transparent objects, glass or plexiglass, because I showed you before this example with a glass tube. Can open and reopen this glass tube.
You clicked on the lookup table, open.
Yes, I see. It's too much. So this is the object. You see the backlight, you see the glass table, and it's a glass on glass. So it's nearly the hardest object you will ever find in photography. Very, very hard to lighten, very hard with all these reflection normally you get on an object, very hard in situations of these semi-transparent parts of the object. in combination with full transparent objects, and we get a quite nice mask as well and a quite nice result. So you see it's working, and it's working on a whiter background if you have a cardboard maybe placed here as well. It's no problem.
Maybe you can switch to the mask view on the top left.
Sorry?
Maybe you can switch to the mask view, the second button, yeah? And put the handles completely to the outside. That's a photo of the inverted mask, and if you shoot mask or transparent subjects, it's very important to have a very homogeneous background, and that's the reason why we developed our own hardware systems, because with LED lighting we can make the background very smooth and homogeneous. And if you use, for example, a flashlight for the backlighting, you always have a spot in the middle of the subject, and it falls down to the outside. And if you compress the mask with the both handles in the histogram, it will, until you have compressed the complete background so it's away, you also have compressed a big part of the transparent stuff inside. And if you pick the color values of the mask in Photoshop, you will see that you have a difference maybe of 5 to 10 values in RGB. And if you make your own background bounce a light to white paper or to white wall, you can pick the values in the mask, and you have differences maybe around 20, 30, 50. And if you try to compress values around 30 or 50 in the mask, the glass goes away too. So that's the biggest trick in Mask Integrator and the whole luminance masking system, to have an most possible even background. And that's the reason why we manufactured the edge of the glass turntable and the backlight and the complete lighting system, that it's as homogeneous as possible.
I'd like to thank you all for today, and hopefully you have a nice day. In Germany we still have rain, what we need, and see you the next time to the next webinar. Thanks for all.
And thanks a lot for your attention and your interest in Mask Integrator and our product photography systems. As we mentioned, we aim to do this kind of webinars about e-commerce photography and its different facets on a monthly basis. So hope you enjoyed this webinar and see you in the next session.
If you are interested to follow our live webinars and join the discussion with our customers, please sign our newsletter at pictureinstruments.com or take a look on our website and see the schedule of the upcoming events.